Hi, I'm Dr. Emily Guest with Tennessee Equine Hospital, and today we're going to be talking about equine acupuncture.
Hey, Dr. Emily, so I just had a couple questions for you. What's involved in an equine acupuncture appointment?
So when I go see a horse for acupuncture, the first thing I like to do is talk to the owner about any issues that horse may be having, any problems they've noticed while riding, or any medical issues that horse has had in the past. After that, I'll perform a diagnostic acupuncture exam on the horse. What that involves is palpation of the acupuncture meridians on the horse's body and looking for any reactive points along those meridians. Once that reactive points are identified, those points might be points that need to be treated themselves, or they might give us information about what may be causing issues elsewhere in the horse. For example, there's several points on the horse's neck and shoulder and chest that indicate that the horse is experiencing pain in its front feet. So there's a lot of information that we can get from that exam, and it also helps identify areas of tight muscles or myofascial restriction. Once all these treatment areas have been identified, then the needles are placed in the horse. Usually we start with some points near the horse's neck and shoulder to help them get used to the sensation of needles, and then place them in the other locations indicated by the diagnostic exam. Once the needles are placed, then I will typically use e-stim, which is an electric stimulation into the needles, which provides additional pain relief and stimulation of the nerves involved.
Awesome. How old does your horse need to be to receive acupuncture?
Any age horse, including foals, can receive acupuncture.
Okay. And what are some conditions that would benefit your horse by receiving acupuncture treatments?
So acupuncture is great for several things. One of the things that it works really well for is pain control. So acupuncture, especially electric acupuncture, has been shown to cause the body to release hormones and opioids that reduce pain in that area. So pain associated with training, muscle soreness in the horses, back, neck, or hindquarters, or pain associated with arthritis, laminitis, or old age all respond well to acupuncture. Acupuncture is also really great for nerve problems. So if a horse has some sort of injury causing facial nerve paralysis or shoulder swinging or something like that, then acupuncture can be a really helpful modality. Another example that acupuncture can be used for is intestinal problems such as mild colics. Some colics require surgery or other treatments to be resolved, but some gas or spasmodic colics can be resolved with the help of acupuncture, which stimulates increased GI motility.
Awesome. How can horse acupuncture be integrated with Western medicine?
Acupuncture should always be just a piece of the treatment for any horse. So there are some things that acupuncture cannot effectively treat, and thus it should be used in conjunction with traditional Western medicine techniques. Not in place of. So depending on what's wrong with the horse, that might include a traditional lameness exam, diagnostic imaging, blood work, or any other number of Western treatments.
Great. And how will a veterinarian determine if acupuncture is right for my horse?
Your veterinarian will perform an exam, physical exam, or lameness exam on your horse and identify issues that may respond well to acupuncture. For example, if your veterinarian identifies back soreness in your horse, or other problems such as neck soreness, like we talked about, nerve issues, anything like that, they might then identify acupuncture as a good treatment option.
Great. Thanks, Dr. Emily.
If you have any questions regarding this or any other topic, please give us a call at our main hospital at 615-591-1232 or visit our website at www.tnequinehospital.com. We are always here to help you and your horse.